Hello, my name is Xander. Welcome to the ORM Mastery course, Level 1 for Beginners. This tutorial is part of the YouTube edition playlist, Django Database ORM Mastery. You can find a link to this playlist in the video description, where you'll find all the tutorials associated to this course. In this tutorial, we learn how to insert data into a single table utilizing the save function. If you would like to follow along step by step, you can download our base Django project, code base 1. There is a link in the video description to that code. Now, if you are not familiar with Django and how to start a new Django project, there is also a video guide on how to download and start the project. Again, there is a link in the video description to that. If you like this course and would like to learn more, then do consider our course on Udemy, Django Database ORM Mastery Level 1. The actual thumbnail might change over time, but just look for Created by Very Academy. There is a link in the video description to the course. That is always going to give you the best price for the course. The setup guide should leave you right here, where we can then go ahead and Python 3, manage by, and then shell. That takes us into the shell, so we can start working with the database here connected to our Django project. So let's bring in the tools that we're going to need to get started. So we are going to be working again with the brand table. So we're going to need to import that into our terminal here. And then once we've done that, let's just go ahead and have a look to see what's already inside of the table. Now, if you have moved from the previous tutorial, likelihood is that we have some data already in our table. So we do a dot all to have a look at that, and then we can press up again and then just delete and we'll start fresh. So that will just remove everything from our brand table. It is always recommended that you type in the code yourself. However, you may not have already found in every tutorial there is a markdown file with all the code that we've been utilizing in that tutorial. You of course can go ahead and download that and start with that as a base to help you type out the code, or maybe just copy and paste into the terminal. Right, so let's talk about the save method. Now, this is a little bit more complicated than it might seem in actual fact. So let me just do this. So we can see here, this is an example here of all the attributes of the save method. And you can see there's quite a few, so there's quite a lot to talk about here in the save method. At this stage in our development, I'm just going to utilize this in a very simplistic way, just building upon our knowledge rather than delving deep into the different attributes that we can utilize. We will follow up this tutorial. You've probably already seen it, the next tutorial, where we go ahead and compare save and create. So we will go a little bit deeper into the functionality of the save function or method. So hang on with that. And then of course at level 2, we'll go in a little bit deeper. So for now, let's just concentrate on using it in a very kind of simplistic way to save data into our database. So we can now see the format that we need to utilize here. We have a model and then we can append with .save to save the data or the object. So let's go ahead now and define our model, which is the brand table, and then we don't need dot objects in this case, so we just need to now define the tables and the data. So we have a brand ID table equals, let's go for 10 or 100, and then we can then go for the name equals, and then whatever the name is. Okay. So we can just append that with .save. There we go. So we can just run this and it should save the data into the database. I think I already have some other data. Yep, so we can see that has been saved into the database. So typically you're going to find in other examples that the format is going to look slightly different. So we could then add our data, we'll prepare our data into the variable here and then use that to then save. So this is going to work exactly the same. Now, there's a lot of flexibility here. Let's say that with the save method. So for example, we could add additional data. Take for example, we didn't have a name here. So let's just append this. So we could add now more data or specify more data. So let's say name equals Knight 1000. Let's give that a go. So we can go ahead. I'll just copy and paste this all in and run that. So let's go ahead and have a look to see if that's inserted. And we can see that that has been inserted into the database. So for those who aren't very familiar with the idea of primary keys, let's just talk a little bit about primary keys, and we'll explore that utilizing the save method. We have been using the brand table so far, and this brand table does have a primary key, a unique identifier that we can utilize in our table. We've defined this primary key manually in the model, in the code. So what we find here is that in other tables, Django has automatically created our primary key because we haven't defined it manually. So let me just show you that to give you more of a visual demonstration. So in our models here, let's just go down, we'll drop this down. Let's just go down to the category table here. Now this category table is using MPTT, which is modified pre-order tree traversal. It basically is just a technique for storing data, hierarchical data in your database. So we can ignore that, but you can see that there's some fields here. Now, something that we haven't defined in this table is the primary key. So we can see we have name, slug, is active, parent, and we will find that more tables are added through this MPTT module here. But we can just ignore that for now. Right, so let's go into the actual database. Where are we? Here. So here we have the SQLite extension. So I just open up the database. If we then go into the category table, we'll find that there's a few more fields than what we can see there defined in our model. And one of them is the ID. So you can see the key here refers to the fact it's a primary key. So like I said, although we haven't defined that in our model, Django is providing that primary key for us automatically. So if I just compare that to the brand table, we've manually added our primary key here. So Django hasn't provided us that particular field. So we go back into the table here. So we had ID there in category. So if we go back into the brand, you can see that here we have brand ID because we've defined our primary key manually. So hopefully that's better emphasized here in this view. We can see that we've created our brand ID here, primary key, and you can see that this is automatically created by Django, this ID primary key in the other tables. Now this field is auto incrementing. So every time we add a new object or a new row and more data into our database, it will auto increment this number. So the first object, first piece of data I insert into this table, it will have an ID of 1, and then the second data we insert will have 2, and so on and so on. So that means when we insert or save data into our database, we don't need to actually specify the ID because that's just going to be automatically created by our database. So let's go ahead and go back into our model here. So we're going to now add some data to our category table. Now, all we need to do here in actual fact is worry about the name, the slug, and is active. So we don't need to worry about parent here or up some of the other fields that you saw in the table. That's all going to be generated by our MPTT extension or module. So let's give this a go. First of all, we're going to need to import it in. So category. So we just add that in. So I'll bring up the console here. Just clear the console. So I'm going to now include category. So we now have access to the category table. So let's go ahead and create our fields and our data. So name equals, so this is going to be a category called trainers. And then we have a slug. So a slug is, if you're not familiar with a slug is a string that is usable as a URL. So for example, we couldn't have this as a URL. It has spaces. So, and we need to format in a way typically with the dash here in a way that the URL can utilize. So let's go ahead and now add slug. Yep. So trainers and then is active. So this is just going to specify whether the category is active or not, whether it should be shown to the user. Maybe a seasonal category like Christmas would need to be disabled throughout the year and then activated at Christmas. So is active equals true. And then we use the save method here. So x equals save to save that. And then we give this a go. Okay, so we've got an unexpected word, a slug. So you can see the reason why that is because I'm using category, but I haven't actually specified that table. So let's go ahead and specify the actual category table. We'll try this again. Looks like it's worked okay. So let's now have a look at the category table, category.objects.all. We'll have a look at that. So you can see that it looks like we've inserted that data into the database. So using the SQL Explorer extension, let's just have a look at the category table here, and we can actually see the data in the database. So notice, like I mentioned, that we haven't specified the ID field, but that's auto-incrementing here. And at the moment, it's number one. So if I add some more data into the database, so let's just add some more data. And then we probably need to do a refresh here, show the table again. We can now see that's auto-incremented to number two. So there we have a basic overview of utilizing the save function to save data or objects into the database. In the next tutorial, we'll learn a little bit more about some of the different features that the save method provides.